The invention of induction motors is the game changer in modern industry, and controlling their speed based on your requirement or application makes you a real winner. There are several ways to control the speed of an AC or induction motor. These include mechanical methods like using gears, adjusting the number of motor poles, or controlling the frequency and voltage of the power supply. Among these, changing the frequency and voltage is the most practical and efficient method. This is because it provides precise control without mechanical wear and reduces energy waste. Whenever you need a change in motor speed, you don't want to modify it mechanically. Instead, you can get it done on single click with the help of a modern advanced device called a variable frequency drives or VFDs. Welcome to today's video where we'll break down variable frequency drives or VFDs in simple and easy to understand terms. By the end, you'll know exactly what a VFD is, how it works, and why it's so important in modern systems. A variable frequency drive is a device that controls the speed of an electric motor. It adjusts the frequency and voltage of the power supplied to the motor, allowing precise control over its speed. Think of it as a speed controller for motors. Before we go further, let's quickly explain what frequency is. Frequency refers to how many times a wave, like an electrical signal, repeats in 1 second. It's measured in hertz. For example, in many countries, the standard electrical frequency is 50 or 60 hertz, meaning 50 or 60 cycles per second. Let's have a look on key components of VFD and how do they work? A VFD or variable frequency drive has 4 key components: a rectifier, a DC bus, an inverter, and a control unit. First, the rectifier converts AC power to DC. Next, the DC bus stores this power. The inverter changes it back to AC, but at the desired frequency and voltage. Finally, the control unit manages the entire process. Before going further, please have a look on our previous videos about a rectifier and an inverter to understand the concept in detail. The rectifier is the first step in the VFD. It takes alternating current or AC from the power source and converts it into direct current or DC. This is crucial for stable power conversion. The DC bus stores the converted DC power using capacitors or inductors. This ensures the system has a steady and reliable DC source of energy to draw from. Next, the inverter converts the stored DC power back into AC. But here's the key: it can change the frequency and voltage of this power, which directly controls the motor speed. The control unit is the brain of the VFD. It takes input from the user or sensors and decides how fast the motor should run. It sends precise instructions to the inverter to make it happen. This makes the VFD a preferred choice for automation. We can control the motor speed with VFD just by sending a control signal from control systems like PLC or DCS. Okay, it's time to summarize. Let's put it all together. The VFD takes power from the source, converts it to DC, stores it, and then converts it back to AC at the right frequency and voltage for the motor. It's a seamless and efficient process. VFDs are used in countless applications, from controlling pumps and fans in industrial plants to improving the efficiency of heating and cooling systems in buildings. Anywhere you need precise motor control, you'll likely find a VFD. That's the wrap for today's video. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more engineering insights. See you in the next video.